Hey everyone, it's Justin here again. This is my friend Alokia.
Hi!
She's a special guest and we're really excited to do a video on our predictions and kind of give a preview on the U.S. Nationals this upcoming year for 2016. And Alokia, I'm actually going to let you do a lot of the talking because most of you probably know my opinions. So, how should we start?
You know what? Let's start with pairs because I think there's sort of less to discuss with them. So,
okay.
I don't think there's any question in anyone's minds who's going to win this. It's going to be Alexa and Chris. I'm a little unhappy with their inconsistency on their triple jumps this year, to be completely honest. And I'm sure they are as well, because that's something they really worked on this summer. But, you know, it is what it is. I think they know they're going to win. So, you know, they're going to go for the quad twist. They're going to try to keep improving their consistency at Nationals so that they can do better at Worlds, I think. So, I think the real story here is Marissa and Mervyn versus Tara and Danny, honestly.
Yeah.
I like Marissa and Mervyn a hell of a lot better.
I
think
they're
better skaters, right? They're way better skaters. They're way more captivating. Tara and Danny don't seem really as together. They don't really skate as a pair, in my opinion, and they're a little jolty.
Mm-hmm.
Best way to put it. But unfortunately, they're a little more consistent. So I think they might edge Marissa and Mervyn out, which is really sad because I do know that Marissa wants to go to Worlds in Boston in her hometown. But I don't know that that's going to happen for them. What do you think?
So I agree with you with Alexa and Chris. I think they will win even if they make mistakes.
Yeah.
It's just really unfortunate to see the mistakes that they are making because it's not just Chris not missing the side-by-side jumps. Alexa too.
Yeah.
And what is up with that throw quad twist?
Oh my god.
That was so weird.
That
used to be their money element. And I'm sorry. And it seems like because that's at the beginning of their long program.
Yeah.
They miss it. It like messes
it,
them up.
Yeah. I don't know, I hope that they but go back to the drawing board on it. I know maybe they backed off a little on their off-ice exercises. I know that Alexa does a lot of just core strength, and maybe she needs to get herself back to that just so that perhaps for her own mind she's more prepared for it.
That's
that
right.
Might be part of the problem is she doesn't necessarily think she's strong enough.
So what do you think has to change? Delilah's coaching technique or maybe Alexa and Chris with their mindset with training?
I think their mindset with training.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's fundamentally the issue. I think they're trying to train like champions, but they're not really achieving that goal right now, which is a little unfortunate because they really do have a lot of potential, I think.
Yeah, and then as you said earlier, the money right here is for who's going to win the silver medal.
Yeah.
I think it's going to go to Tara and Danny, just because they're more consistent.
Yeah.
But I prefer Marissa and Mervyn.
Yeah.
I told you earlier today that I think Danny and Tara, I don't want to say they skate like juniors, but I don't see them as a senior pair yet.
No.
So maybe they're in like an awkward stage, like growing as a pair together.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think there's such a huge difference in maturity levels between the two individuals. It's very hard to bring that together. And perhaps that's also a little
and
bit what they're struggling
maybe
with.
Maybe it's because there's an age gap, too.
That age gap is
yeah.
huge. And it's always tough with that kind of an age gap to bring it together,
mm-hmm.
especially when the younger person is like, you know, like around 20-ish years
yeah.
old. That's kind
I will
of,
say if both teams are clean, I would give it to Mervyn and Marissa.
Yeah, absolutely. If
mm-hmm.
both teams are clean, I think there isn't a question in my mind that they would win. But, yeah, it's just Mervyn, lend those triples, please.
Yes.
Come on. We want you to. We want you to do well. So I think we're both in agreement. Alexa
yeah.
and Chris, Tara and Danny, Marissa and Mervyn.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah, is there, like, are running for the pewter medal? Matt Sedlage and Madeline Aird, are they competing? They might be out for injury.
They might be out for injury.
Okay.
I don't know. I'm going to be honest. I don't really keep up with American pairs that much.
No one blames you.
Yeah, because we don't have the most competitive pairs program. I hope that changes because I really love to see some great competitive pairs domestically, not just internationally.
I think it could really change.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
it really could. I think if we had the mindset that it's not a failure to do pairs instead of singles, I think that's what has to change. Yeah, otherwise we're not going to ever get a good
mm-hmm.
competitive pairs lineup ever.
That's true.
Yeah. Okay, all right. Yeah. Shall we move on to dance?
Okay. Dance is all you.
Okay. Okay. I wish Maya and Alex could win. I love their programs. I love them as people. They're really awesome. I love their free dance this year. It's so mature. It's so them. And I think for the first time, they've really gotten them. Like, the Michael Jackson program, I felt was, like, very Alex. But I feel like this their free dance this year is very them. And I really like the concept of their short dance. And I think they do a really good job of executing it, but at the same time, I do see the criticism for making them look like juniors.
Mm-hmm.
And for that reason, I think it was a little bit of a mistake on Marina's
yeah.
part to give that to them. I do think they do a good job of what they have, though. But, I mean, even a 2-point deficit in the short program against Maddie and Evan is enough.
Mm-hmm.
Because they can't make that up in the free dance. And we saw what happened at the Grand Prix final with those twizzles with Maddie and Evan. Like, the U.S. judges are going to give Maddie and Evan the title, unfortunately. I'm not, like, with Maddie and Evan, and this is going to sound absolutely terrible, but I don't think there's a them. There's Madison Chalk skating around. And,
I think it's funny you say that because I think Evan is a better skater than Maddie.
Yeah,
but
absolutely.
You watch her more because
you
she sells it.
Yeah, and like Charlie and Meryl had this problem, but
mm-hmm.
Charlie worked on it and it took a couple of years, but he overcame that. And you watched him at least a little bit during Scheherazade.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas, like, you never watch Evan ever, and I don't feel like he's making a conscious decision to try to improve.
Mm-hmm.
And that really irks me with skaters, is like, if you know you have a weakness, and I'm sure he's heard this because everyone thinks it, everyone
yeah.
knows Madison Chalk. Skating around, dragging Evan around. Like, you improve it. That's like, you're doing this for 40 hours a week plus. Like, do something about you not being as charismatic as your partner. I don't think there's any excuse
mm-hmm.
at this point. What are your thoughts on those two teams?
Yeah, so I just kind of slightly started following dance this season, and I will say the free dance by the Shibutani's is amazing. I just can't believe that it's such a crowd favorite, but the judges
yeah.
haven't been rewarding them.
I
especially
know.
The Grand Prix final. That was a winning performance
it
to me.
It really was.
I don't care if you were like fourth after the short program. That should have lifted you up.
Absolutely. Like, that program makes you feel emotion.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like it really makes you feel emotion. And I love that. Like, that's
true.
What you're supposed to do with skating, and especially that particular piece fix you. So, kind of weird story. We had this really intense retreat at my high school, and they played that song after, like, a really intense talk at one of the senior
oh.
high skate, and all of us just bawled. So that, like, piece is such significance to me, and I think they do it justice, which is saying something, but it's like, oh my goodness, like, all the feels are coming, and everyone gets it in the audience, and come on, judges, they should win, but I don't think they're going
yeah.
to.
And Alokia, correct me if I'm wrong, but a lot of people have asked me, and I can't give them an answer because I don't follow dance, but here's why I assume that Maddie and Evan are above the Shibutani's is because overall, they have more sloppy moments, but is it because they do harder technical lifts and harder twizzles? That's not it?
I don't think so. I think that the Shibutani's are actually, they have harder technical content.
Because I can tell they're better skaters.
They're better skaters, and that enables them to do more difficult twizzles,
okay.
that enables them to do more difficult lifts. I think it's because of politics.
All
point.
Because of politics?
I think it's all politics. Dance has been always about politics.
Okay, well, that's unfortunate.
To be complete. Yeah, I mean, it's really sad, but I think Marina, like, had her years of influence. And now that she doesn't have her 2-star teams, Igor's like, well, it's my turn. So, yeah, I think it's just all politics. It's just, it's really unfortunate.
So
and the sibling
think,
team
does Do you think the situation could be better for the Shibutani's if they, like, grew a little more and looked more like adults? Although,
they're doing
teams.
That. They're,
yeah.
I mean, they're doing that with their free dance, and it's not happening. So, at this point, it's like, let's go to, like, they're going to win the silver at nationals. That's fine. Win the silver at nationals. It's okay if they don't have a national title, but bring it up worlds and see if you can change
mm-hmm.
the international judges' minds. because that might help change domestic.
I would say that if Maddie and Evan make a mistake, that they could take advantage of that situation. But it sounds like politics are so much into play that that won't make a difference.
And yeah, I mean, they made a mistake on the Twizzle and still got plus GOE. So
I made a joke about that, and I said all the judges happened to blink at the same time at the Grand Prix final.
It was just sad.
It was so bad.
So bad. Don't do that. Mm. Don't do that, judges. This is why people have a hard time following dance.
I was going to say, I was watching dance and I was confused by the score. So I was like, if I looked at the protocols, will it make it easier for me? And people were like, no. I was like, okay.
It makes no sense. All right, let's talk about Madison Hubble and Zach Donahue. Have you watched?
They were at the Grand Prix final, right?
Yeah.
They were last place.
They were last place. Yeah. Okay, not my favorite team. Honestly, ever.
They weren't as aesthetically pleasing as the first two American teams.
Right, and, like, people will say it's because, like, Maddie isn't, like, the typical pretty princess. I'm like, no, I don't think Tessa was the typical pretty princess. But she managed to really emote, and I don't really see that from either Maddie or Zach, to be completely honest.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, at least if one of them was emoting, then, you know, you could, you know, reward them a little bit. But I don't really see the commitment to the program that I see from, like, Maya and Alex. So,
And what's their history been like at Nationals?
They've always been, like, third or fourth. So, when it used to be, like, Marilyn, Charlie, Maddie, and Evan, and the Shipitanis, and then the Hubbles came in fourth. And then before Maddie and Evan either were a thing or became big, they were, like, in, like, third, fourth place. So, they're always in the third, fourth spot.
I see.
I don't know that they'll ever come up. And with Caitlin and John Luke sort of on the rise, I think that this might be their last year on the world team.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense.
And they've made a dramatic change. They made a big coaching change to Montreal, and I don't think that's helped them, unfortunately. So, they just need to emote. I think if they want to do anything at this point.
I think they've peaked, right?
They,
I think I can tell that by watching them.
Yeah, I don't think that they're really going to get any better. But they're going to win bronze this year, I'm pretty sure. They're going to, because they got, I mean, they made their Grand Prix final. So they're going to win bronze. They're going to go to Worlds. Yeah, they'll be respectable. It'll be
the
good.
The question is, are they aware of it? Because they look disappointed by their scores at the Grand Prix final.
Well, you have to have some skater delusion, right? In order to, like... And, like, last year, I remember this Facebook post by them when they were, like, finally back on the world team where we belong, because it was, like...
Where they belong.
Where they belong, and I'm like... Maybe it was the year before that, but, yeah, it was, like, that when you have... I'm sorry. When you have the Shims, Marilyn, Charlie, and Maddie, and Evan, like, it's very hard to make a justification to put you up there with them. The only reason you're on the team is because Marilyn and Charlie... weren't there. Like, and everyone knows it. So, they will get overtaken next year. I'm confident of it. By the next team I sort of want to discuss, which is John Luke and Caitlin. So, first of all, we're in the Seattle area, so shout out John Luke, because you're from here. We don't get many good skaters from here.
I see them skate. I think they're really cute.
They're good. That's the word, cute.
Oh, is it?
That's
bad
the problem.
They can dance?
I think it's bad.
That is true because Meryl and Tessa are very womanly.
They're very womanly.
Yeah.
And I think Caitlin's trying to be a woman and it's not really coming through because she's like 18 or something. And she's like, I know Meryl, she's listed Meryl Davis as one of her mentors and it's great, but there's a difference between like having a mentor and, like, copying them. And I think she's trying to copy Meryl a lot of things. Like, Meryl's, like, super put together all the time. Like, there's no hair out of place. Her nails are done. Her face is perfect. Like, it's ridiculous. And Caitlin's the same way.
Mm-hmm.
Like, her nails are done. Her face is perfect all the time. But Meryl always looked her age. Like, when she was 23, 22, she looked that age. But when she was 26, 27, she looked that age. She just looked like a really polished version of that age. Whereas Caitlin... like, I feel like she's trying to look like she's older than she is. I'm like, no, embrace your youth. Like, try, you know, work with it and look good for your age. But don't try to be something you're not.
Yeah.
It just comes off as really scripted.
And
I think
overall being very age appropriate is important in ice skating.
Yeah, absolutely. It's really appropriate. So, especially in dance. So, I don't like the Greenscape this year, to be honest.
Okay.
It's terrible. And I could like their short dance without the tiara, without the long skirt.
Oh, she's wearing a tiara?
Yeah.
No.
I'm just like,
boy.
Past the princess phase. Come on. Like, it's like, I have a hard time with it. But let's not do the pretty princess thing. That's
or you
not,
don't have to take the princess concept too literally.
Too literally.
Yeah.
Like, there's no reason to do that. So let's just not.
Mm.
Yeah. So, but, you know, fourth place this year, that's okay. I'm feeling they'll send them to four continents. Like, again, like they did last year.
So who would miss out on four continents?
Double up on who?
Okay.
Yeah, so
mm.
that's what happened last year. I think the same thing's going to happen this year.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, just so that they get more experience
okay.
on the senior international stage. So I'm okay with that decision, but I do think they'll win bronze next year, and I'm excited for their future. Just, you know, don't do pretty princess programs and... You know,
I see. How deep
yeah.
is the dance field in America, like past the podium placers?
I don't follow it that
well.
Okay,
I
kind of follow it more on the international level than I do on the.
Mm-hmm.
So the people that hit the international level, I know, but I don't really know the domestic
okay.
dance
that makes
as
sense.
Well. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. Okay. All right. I think that's. Yeah.
Dance
I think
good.
That's good for dance. All right. Should we do men or ladies first?
Let's do men's.
Let's do men. Okay. Do you want to start with this?
Sure.
Okay.
I'm just going to lay out my predictions.
Go.
I think it's the season for Max Aaron to regain his title back. Strong showing at Skate America. It seems like he is improving. Artistry, you know, we can say what we want. It's still not great. I don't think it ever will be. But the work with Philip Mills is paying off. The thing that I'm most excited about seeing from him this season is getting the quad and the triple combination, because we've seen a lot of attempts, but he doubles that second jump, which is annoying because he can do a triple.
And he can do it in practice.
Mm-hmm.
I've watched him do it
oh,
in
I
practice.
Oh, I've seen him do it on warm-up.
Yeah,
yeah,
in warm-up. But, like, he takes often a lot of time to set up for it.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have a
There's
program.
There's no transition into
yeah.
a quad. Yeah, so I'm excited about Max Aaron. I'm pretty confident he'll regain the gold medal.
Yeah.
And then second place, it's a toss-up for me between Jason Brown and Nathan Chen. Jason, I'm just unsure about his injury because he has the consistency. I know he can bring it. If he makes a mistake, it's usually on the quad.
Yeah.
That's the big question there. And then also the triple axel sometimes.
Right.
But it's U.S. Nationals. He's a reigning champion. I think they're going to give him the program component marks.
Yeah, and everyone loves him.
And everyone loves
like,
him, yeah.
It's hard to not love this kid. Like, I'll walk in. So I live in Colorado. I'm here for break. So, like, I'll walk in to the Monument rink, and Jason's, like, the happiest person on earth. I'm like, I needed that after a really, really long week of just engineering. I'm a chemical engineering major, so my life is awful. And so, like, at the end of a long week, sometimes I'll drive down there.
And it's genuine, too.
It's so genuine. He's like, hey, how are you doing? Like, he's super excited. It's hilarious. It's like, thank you. Like, you're tonic. You're my tonic for for awful, awful schooling. So
definitely. And then Nathan Chen, I just like that he's consistent. He
yeah.
needs to grow a lot artistically, but he's challenging himself with the jumps, which sometimes worries me. The Grand Prix final, what he originally told the media that he was going to attempt four quads in the
yeah.
long program, and I think it turned into three attempts, and one of them
was clean,
maybe.
I mean, like, this is U.S. Nationals. The only person with a decent quad is Max Aaron.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't need that many quads. And I think he, especially because he's going to have to do a longer program.
Unless his goal is winning. Because someone told me on Twitter, because I, like, posted
yeah.
that. If he wants to win, sure, attempt more quads.
But
then,
I think he only
yeah.
needs one clean quad because he has better artistry than Max.
I actually think his goal should be the silver.
Yeah, absolutely. Or just making the world team at
yeah.
this point.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just, like, get on the world team, because he also has a longer program to deal with. He's been practicing the short junior program
mm-hmm.
for, you know, the entire season, so...
That's true.
Yeah, I think, you know, make the world team is a good... I think that's a good goal for him.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think he should aim for the title. I think that should just be setting himself up for disappointment,
right.
but, you know, I think if he makes... the world team at nationals, he will be our star internationally.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
And, yeah, and that will, he'll have time to work up to the big program. Maybe he could add more than one quad at that
mm-hmm.
point, but I don't think it's wise for nationals.
Yeah.
And he doesn't need it for nationals. Our field is not good at quads.
Yeah. I don't have a prediction for the pewter medalist, so that's my podium. What about yours?
Okay, so I'm with you on Max.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think he's going to win this. And this is purely because Jason got injured so, like, not very long ago.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a little worried for him. He's probably going to dial it back a little bit just so he doesn't get injured again. So I think Max is going to win this regardless of what happens. One thing I will say is I think he needs more than a couple weeks of Philip Mills to sort out his artistry.
Max,
I think, like, after...
I actually think he's 2 years late.
He's late. But I think what would actually help him is if he fundamentally left Tom for a couple months, like, if he went to California, and if he spent, like, after Worlds until, like, August with Phil. And, like, I know that's when Tom, like, wants to get, like, the strength and power training, and but that's something that Max can't do himself. He's a driven guy. But I think he needs someone on him all the time about artistry, because, like, when I was with Tom, like, Tom is very on about, like, he's good with jumps, but he's, like, he doesn't always hammer people on pointing their toes,
mm-hmm.
on, like, extending your line and on stretching, but it's just not his focus. And it's just not in his nature, and there's nothing wrong with that. But I think, you know, Max is, you know, musicality isn't in his nature, so he's
gonna
need some extra attention.
And Philip is not bad with the technical stuff.
No,
he's not a specialist,
not
but
no.
he's not bad.
He's not bad, and at the very least, he can be like the whipmaster,
mm-hmm.
like, do this. And I think that's all Max needs is someone to be on him.
And Max is staying in skating for a reason, because he could have retired after the Olympic season
and
not making it. Mm-hmm.
I think he fundamentally enjoys what he does. Like, he gets on the ice, he has a big smile on his face,
mm-hmm.
super focused in practice. He loves what he does.
Now, question for you. Did it worry you that he skated so poorly at the short program in the Trophy Eric Bompard?
A little bit. And
it does for me, too.
Yeah.
But he redeemed himself a week later at some...
At one of
senior
the
competition.
Yeah, I think the one in I can't remember which
Eastern
European country it was,
yeah.
like in Hungary or Estonia or something. But yeah, I think So he tends to do well at nationals.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I think that's when Tom is really good at making sure his skaters peak, like he did this with Rachel Flatt too.
Mm-hmm.
So I think he'll have a good nationals. So yeah, it's a little worrying, but yeah, Jason, I'm just. Oh my god, I think he will come in second, because the judges love him, the crowd loves him. It's Minneapolis is close enough to Chicago that a lot of his friends will be able to come up and support him.
Good point.
Yeah, so he'll have the crowd behind him, and he's just so enthusiastic. I love his free skate so much this year. It reduced me to tears in practice. And at Broadmoor, those are the couple times I've seen it in person. And
I actually forgot what his free skate was, because he backed out of an NHK trophy
mm-hmm.
wasn't at the final. I just now remember it.
Yep, it's
yeah.
so beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And if he, like, the thing is that Roheen does good choreography, but at the beginning of the season it's really rocky, because, like, I think all the skaters have to work sections on it, otherwise there's
mm-hmm.
no way in hell you're going to figure out Roheen's choreography, so it seems very disconnected
mm-hmm.
at the beginning of the season, but when, by the nationals, I think everyone sort of figured out the story behind it, how to make it one connected program, and so by then, like, I mean, his Riverdance program came together so well a couple years ago, I think the same thing's going to happen with the season. I felt it was a little choppy at Skate America. It was like,
mm-hmm.
it was section by section by section, and now by nationals, he's going to have one fluid program.
For some weird reason, I remember his free skate the best from, like, a senior B, where
from
he only did, like,
yeah,
like, two triples and the rest intended doubles.
Yeah, and that's when it was best, because he didn't have to focus on the
triples.
Really
nice,
it was, yeah, that's when I, like, near, that's when I cried. I was filming it for TSL, and oh my god, like, I was trying not to cry because, like, my hands would shake.
Yeah.
While I was sad. I told him that. I was like, Jason, I cried it for. He's like, oh my god, you're so sweet. Thank you so much. Like, in general.
So, he could potentially have another moment in the free program.
He's gonna have
at
a moment.
Nationals. Okay,
he's
good.
Gonna have a moment. Like, I'm positive. So that's why he's gonna come in second, I think, over Nathan Chen. I think Nathan Chen's our best third option, and I'd
great.
Love to send him to Worlds. But I think that should be his only goal: get to Worlds and shine at Worlds. Show what the U.S. is capable.
Could they send him
Worlds.
To Junior Worlds and Worlds, or is that too much of a time?
Not
match?
Anymore. I don't think there's
okay.
a rule against it. Yeah. So yeah, I think which is pretty new, but. Yeah, so
mm-hmm.
let's just set him to Worlds, and if not, he'll go to Junior Worlds and rock the house there, so that's good. Adam Rippon, we need to discuss this
oh,
kid.
Yeah. Okay, I can't believe that he, like, just fell out of the because he has the potential to be on the podium. He was silver medalist last
yeah.
year.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
and he's gorgeous, but, like...
an amazing skater.
He's so beautiful, like, he's good skills and such, good artistry, but that... freaking quad lutz, man. Like, I can't... He needs to take it out at this point, I think. Especially out of the short. Maybe in the free, but not in the short. And
I'm wondering how he feels after seeing or hearing about Booyoung Jin from China landing it consistently with it being called rotated
yeah.
with positive grades of execution. I mean, that's got to be a blow to his ego.
Well, you saw the TSL interview where he was talking about that, right? He's like, there's this little, like, Chinese junior that...
Oh, that's
to...
right. That's
yeah.
right.
Yeah. yeah. And he was just like, like, honey.
oh,
like,
that's where he said no, honey? Okay.
Yeah, I was just like, honey, no. And I'm like, he's aware of it, and he's not trying to compete with that, which
mm-hmm.
is good. Like, he knows his body's limitations, but...
So he's doing it for personal reasons, but if that's going to keep you from reaching your goal...
Yeah, I think
he
just...
take it out?
Yeah, do three triples in the short. No one will think you any worse for it. The only...
Mm-hmm. I'm going to judge you.
Right, there are only two skaters at Nationals that I think have a chance of landing a quad in the short, and that's Max and Nathan, and they're going to outplace you regardless of what you do.
We're
so. Going
to see a lot of failed quad attempts,
oh
even in the
God.
Short program.
It's
so, going to
be bad.
I think it says something if you like, take the safe route.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, that's how Jason came in fourth at Worlds last year.
Mm.
So, I mean, there's nothing wrong with it, especially with the U.S. men's field as it is. Like,
mm-hmm.
I think we have a deep field with no quads. And so, like, doing the clean program, you know, goes a long way
mm-hmm.
in a lot of respects.
I
so,
wish other U.S. men could do that, like, internationally.
Absolutely. And that's where Nathan comes in. But I don't know. I think he just needs to cut the BS. like, when he trains. It's... I think he makes so many excuses for himself. Like, it's like when I'm running... and I don't want to, like, go for an extra 5 minutes to, like, push myself up from a 5K
mm-hmm.
to a 10K. And I just make excuses like, well, like, I didn't have much to drink this morning, or I didn't eat well
mm-hmm.
last night, or I didn't get enough sleep. Like, I'll make excuses for myself, and then I'll have to, like, slap myself on the head and be like, no, you're running for 5 minutes. Like,
yeah.
it doesn't matter. And I think that he makes excuses for himself like
mm-hmm.
that. And it's a problem.
Yeah.
It's turned into a problem.
I can tell it's a mental issue for him.
Yeah.
And I can tell when he's scared on the ice.
Yeah.
Like, it's like that first posing
yeah.
moment, and I'm like, oh, crap.
Yeah. But I think it's just because he can't trust his training, because he doesn't train as hard as he could.
Mm.
So that's what it comes down to, where someone like Jason can trust his training, because
yeah.
the guy works his butt off every single day at the rink, so.
Mm-hmm. On a mountain, right?
Yeah, on a mountain.
Right.
At 7,000 feet, you know, like, 2,000 feet higher, no, about 1,000 feet higher from where I live. 1,000 feet above Colorado Springs, even, so.
Mm.
Yeah, if he can do it there, he can do it anywhere, and he knows it, so.
Cool. Someone
yeah.
else I can think about for a pewter option is Ross Miner, who had his moment.
Yeah.
Which Grand Prix was it? He was bronze. Was it Ross Telecom Cup?
Yeah.
Yeah. That was
yeah.
a surprise for him.
It was a surprise, and I think he's just so inconsistent.
Especially at Nationals.
Especially at Nationals. Like, he had that amazing year, and then there's that
and then he was supposed to peak at Boston.
I
know. At Boston. That totally
didn't
happen.
That did not happen.
No.
It was bad. Yeah. I love Ross. And I love watching him.
I like his programs this
I
year.
I love his programs every year. He's just...
I just like that tribute to the Boston.
The
body,
that was
no,
weird.
That
was
weird. Good.
That was awkward. But yeah. No, I love his programs. And I love his skating. And I wish he could, you know, become more consistent.
Mm-hmm.
And I think he needs a coach change at this point. But it's time
yeah.
for him to leave Boston.
That's true.
So...
Who
I think he could use a Tom as a cry check on him. But there, Vincent quickly mention Vincent Jo.
Oh, he's competing as a senior.
He's competing as a senior. I think he should place top 10, and that's all he could hope for this year. But, oh my gosh, so this kid scares me. Like,
so does he want to be junior national champion?
No.
Like,
oh
boy.
Yeah.
I think that's a nice title to have.
Yeah, I guess.
Okay.
But I think it's more valuable to compete as a senior because the junior world roster also comes from seniors, not just juniors.
Okay.
But Vincent, like, okay, he scares me. Like, he's so intense and he's so quiet and so serious. And then
he
like, yeah, but then he'll like drop a beat and start rapping randomly.
That's what I'm saying. He has
yeah,
yeah,
he scares me to death though. Like, I'm tongue-tied when I talk to this guy. It's so ridiculous. But like, I can talk to like Alex Johnson, who we need to talk about too.
Okay.
Like, I can talk to him fine, and I can talk to like Jordan fine, and I can talk to all these people fine, but I can't talk to this kid. He like makes me so nervous. He's such a hard worker. So Vincent, I hope he does well. I think top 10 finish would be
mm-hmm.
good for him. Grant Hochstein.
Oh, who kind of
yeah.
had a breakout year, fourth place
yeah.
at one of his Grand Prix events. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think he could do really. I actually think he's a solid sixth place.
And he has an okay quad.
He has an okay quad, a little inconsistent.
Mm-hmm.
He could be a little prettier on ice, but
oh really?
He's not
I think
bad.
He's a good
I think he's good. I think he could be a little better, but he's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, if he pulls it together, I think he could really make it. I think this is gonna sound terrible. Not having Caroline at the rink every day is helping him.
Oh yeah.
Because I think it's helping him focus.
Mm-hmm. Part of me feels like he should have peaked a few years ago. I'm not
yeah.
sure if he wasn't given the opportunities or he didn't perform well enough at nationals.
The latter, I think.
Okay.
Yeah. I think, or perhaps a combination of both, but especially the latter.
Okay.
Because one leads to the other. So I think Grant Hochstein will do well. Jordan Moore, we saw on Instagram this morning.
Oh, gosh.
I'm so sad. I love his short program this year so much. The music is so cool.
Mm-hmm.
I know Jordan loves the music, so I hope he keeps the short program for next
and
year.
And he seems like a really nice kid.
Such a nice guy.
I
love
him so much.
So, like, he's such a nice guy. I love him so much. And it's clear that Corey loves him, too.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah, it's hard not to love this guy. So...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm prayers for a speedy recovery, and not just a speedy recovery, but a good recovery that he can get back to full form.
And how old is he? Because he still has
he's
time.
He's 20.
20? Yeah, he has time.
He's got time. I think he has another couple of years before
mm-hmm.
he has to start worrying about his career. But, you know, rest, don't try to do anything too soon. You know, if you have to start in July again, start in July again. Just make
mm-hmm.
a full recovery. I think that's really important for him, that he doesn't start up too soon. Alright, so yeah, I think my podium is Max, Jason, Nathan, and then the 4th, 5th, and 6th are Adam, Tim Delensky, and Grant Hochstein. We didn't cover Tim, did we? We need to cover Tim.
Okay.
We need to talk about Tim. He's done well this year. He's done every competition on Earth.
Skate Canada long program. That was a shining moment.
That
right?
was amazing. That was amazing. And
mm-hmm.
if he... I think that's when he really, like, figured it out for himself.
Mm-hmm.
What he's doing and why he's doing it. So... I think that'll carry him.
If he can skate like that all the time, he's gonna go good
he's
places.
He's gonna, yeah. I don't think he will make the world team this year, even if he skates lights out.
Mm-hmm.
But he's someone to worry about absolutely next year. So this is why Jason needs a quad.
He does.
I think he'll rotate his quad and fall, which is fine.
That's fine. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like it's -1 for fall, -3 on GOE, but he'll have the rotations, which counts.
Mm-hmm.
So
it probably wouldn't affect his second mark that much either.
No. And I think he's worked really hard on when he falls on the quad, making sure the rest of the program's good.
Mm-hmm.
He's really worked hard on that, and that's good. It says a lot for him. So
mm-hmm.
yeah.
A few other names we haven't discussed: Ricky Dornbusch. That's some
Ricky
Dorn in my mind.
Oh my god. Okay.
Hey, so I really. like watching Ricky when he's on. Apparently he's a really good show skater, really good with
his
quad.
Show skater.
I think it's competition pressure. He hasn't learned how to deal with it, or he hasn't trained properly for nationals, or his Grand Prix events.
I think there's a lack of focus with him. So he's a physics major, so I'm a chemical engineering major, and at my school, we have, like, a competition, an unofficial competition with physics majors, whose major is the hardest arts is. Like, they do some hard things that I could not imagine doing. And
mm-hmm.
likewise, like, they don't understand any of our thermo or any of our mass transfer and separation stuff. So I really respect physics majors. They have a tough job in life. And Ricky is a physics major, and it's great that he wants to do that, but, I mean, at the end of my day, I am exhausted from a full day of school, and even if, like, even there's, like, one kid that's only taking one class per semester, he has a rough time, because just the homework from kinetics is enough to derail you for an entire day. It's rough, like, doing, I think, a STEM program at the same time as doing anything else.
And is he a part-time student?
I mean, he has to be a part-time student to skate. But, like, even just that, I think, is too much. So perhaps what he needs to do is find a TAing job. That would actually, I think, be a really good option. So he's familiar with the material, he's still in touch with it, doesn't forget anything, and he interacts with the professors and keeps in touch with them, because that's really important in university studies. But I think he needs to leave school for a bit.
Or
beyond TAing.
Or does he need to leave skating?
Yeah, I think it might be. That's the problem, though. I think he has so much potential.
He does.
So
I can't think I've seen any growth from him artistically.
I
mean, it's hard to grow artistically when you keep falling.
Yes!
I mean, I do like the kid.
Yeah.
You know?
I love him as a person. He's a generally sweet guy, and you want to root for him, but I think it's time he makes a decision. And I think he should. School will always be there for you.
Yeah.
Your education doesn't go away, but your youth does. So perhaps leave school for a bit, focus on skating for a couple of years. If it's not happening, you know it's not going to happen. So then, I mean, physics is a good degree. He will do well in life, so, you know, he does have a good option outside skating, for which I'm excited.
Yeah. Okay, so we've discussed everybody.
I think that's everything.
My prediction for the pewter is between Grant and Adam.
Absolutely.
Can't decide which one, so we'll see.
Oh, Alex, we forgot.
Oh, yeah,
Alex.
Go for it.
he trains hard. I wish he'd train his programs more.
Alex, the really beautiful lyrical skater,
yes.
But is not always on with the jumps.
On with jumps.
Okay.
Yeah, he is going to be at home. In Minneapolis.
Oh, okay.
Or it's not in Minneapolis, it's St. Paul.
St. Paul.
Yeah, sorry. Same thing, it's Minnesota. But that's home for him, so he's going to have the hometown crowd behind him, which is good. But jumps.
I'm sorry, you just have to have the jumps.
You do need to have the jumps. End of story. I don't think he's... I think he might place top 10, but that's it, unfortunately. Before we move on, I do want to mention Josh Ferris.
Who's also from Washington State.
Also from Washington State. So we love him and just love him in general. It's hard not to. I hope he recovers. He sent out that weird tweet earlier this year where he's like, I'm sick of like figure skating, meaning that like everyone gets injured going for these quads. And I hope that that isn't an indication that he's thinking of leaving the sport. Because of injuries.
Although I would
so
understand
many.
If he decided to leave.
Me
he
too.
Has
he's
not
had
been
so
looking.
Many injuries. Yeah, he's had a rough go of it. So it wouldn't shock me in the slightest if that happened. But what do you do? Okay.
If Josh was competitively skating, I would have him for the podium.
Easy. So
even if he did not perform well on the Grand Prix, I would still expect him to bring it at Nationals.
Yeah, because he trains for Nationals really well. I think that's the men.
All right.
All right, ladies.
All right, so we've agreed for the gold medal, it's Gracie versus Ashley.
Yeah.
Let's just stay on that for a little bit. I'm a tad bit more on Team Ashley, not just because I love her. I understand her weaknesses. So on paper, Gracie and Ashley, I think it makes more sense to predict Gracie would win. I think Gracie's head case issue gets more in the way at Nationals than it does for Ashley. But no, Ashley has to be clean. Okay, here's the thing. Whoever's more clean will win.
Yes.
That's just what it is.
Yeah, that's what it is.
They're not going to call Ashley's second triple under rotated.
Yeah, this is US Nationals.
They're not going to call under rotated. Her lets will probably get, you know, just an exclamation point at worst.
She didn't get this one to Skate America, even though she's national champion. That's the first time
this
has happened.
I was upset about that,
so
too.
I don't know that they're on her side.
Oh, don't get me wrong. I believe USFSA loves Gracie
more. Loves Gracie
Ashley.
More, yeah.
But this is a competition. If Gracie falls twice and Ashley doesn't, you know. Gracie
that's
also, she pops her jumps, and a lot of times it's in the short program. Does that same rule still apply to US Nationals?
They use ISU rules.
So then in that case, I'd say, so I think actually right now, but it's who's on top after the short program? I think Whoever wins the short program, I think will win the long.
I think it depends on how badly the other one does. Because if it's like neck and neck, and then it's whoever does a free good better free
okay.
program.
It's usually not neck and neck.
That's usually not. Usually Gracie really had games are short. But her short's been good this year. Except at the Grand Prix final.
Yeah, Trophy Eric Mompard
was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so like she's capable of doing a good short. She's also capable of doing a good long. We just haven't seen it this year.
Mm-hmm.
But I actually think Grace is going to come out on top, to
okay.
be honest. But I agree with you. It's a case of who's going to head case worse.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're both pretty bad at this.
And I would love to say that if they were going to have a head case issue, that it would stay at Nationals. Unfortunately,
yeah, it tends to.
It's a problem all year long, and that's why, you know, a lot of skating fans have a tough time rooting for the American Ladies.
Yeah.
Even though we love them, Ashley Wagner's my best friend.
Yeah.
So, I want her to do so well.
Gracie needs a supportive boyfriend that also kicks her butt. That, yeah, like, I know she's super busy and doesn't have time for it, but I think she just needs someone her age she can talk to at the
mm-hmm.
that's not her sister. Because Carly, okay, like, Carly's wanted to get to national. That's her goal. And so she's probably like, Gracie, you're, like, competing for the national title. Like, I can't relate to you.
Yeah.
Right. And so I think she just needs someone her own age that she can talk to that perhaps isn't in skating, that, like, is outside skating and she can just, like, bitch to. I think that's
mm-hmm.
really what she needs, and someone to really hold her hand. I might not offer Grant Sharon up. There's a kid at my school.
So I never said this before, but I'm surprised that all the young crop of Russian ladies coming up has not been enough motivation for Gracie to kind of
fix
get rid
issues.
Of her mental issues, yeah.
Well,
so I'm not sure what it is that's in her mind that needs to click.
I think she has a motivation to get rid of them. It's just not happening. Because it'll just, I mean, mental problems are not something that you can say, go away, and they'll go
that's
away
true.
Immediately.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
But, and do you have this opinion, as I do? I'm saying if you're a top U.S. lady, you need to skate clean all the time.
All the time.
Senior, like, you may not win because you have stronger competition, but you at least need to put out respectable programs all the time. Like, Michelle
yeah.
Kahn can't go to a senior
no.
B and play second.
No, no, that's not a thing. Yeah, like, you need to, like, this is the United States figure skating in general.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have so many, such legacy skaters behind
mm-hmm.
you. You need to represent them well. And, like, not following up on that legacy, I think, has become a problem for us, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, JSF is being respected very highly because, like, you know, they had some great skaters in the past and they've continued that tradition.
Mm-hmm.
And we've broken ours and it's going to be very hard. And the only way for us to really gain that respect back in the ladies' field is if we have consistent skaters. And we have really never had one except for Rachel Flatt since Michelle Kwan.
Mm-hmm.
And Rachel wasn't a gorgeous skater.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she was consistent with jumps, but she would never earn that second mark, so she didn't earn the respect
yeah.
of anyone. So.
And Alyssa Cisney's successful
oh,
season
God.
Was very short-lived.
I love her so much.
I love her too.
Be better at things.
Yeah.
Ashley, I will say one thing for her. She also needs to cut the BS with
yeah.
that. Especially with Adam. Like, no. Like, there's a time and place to be friends with people. At their rank is not one of them.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the way Max Aaron trains is, and the way Jason Brown trains should be the way that everyone trains. Like, Jason is friends with everyone at the rink. Don't get me wrong. He, like, chats with Mariah and chats with Corey and chats with Jordan. But when he's on the ice, he has that laser focus on and
I've
he trains.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he trains like nobody's business. And so does Max. He does not engage with anyone at the rink at all on a personal level, I don't think.
I kind of want Ashley to be that way because I think Gracie already
yeah.
trains that way.
She does train that way.
Yeah, so
but
it's time for Ashley to
Ashley
laser focus.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
She needs to stop venturing around. She just needs to sit and get her job done and get out. That's
mm-hmm.
her. Yeah. It's a tough one, but I think Grace is going to take it. So,
okay. So
yeah.
we'll see who ends
up being right. I tend to be wrong.
I will say both skaters have the right vehicles this season, because Gracie's known for not having the programs, and I think she does. Oh, you know,
I hate her free skate.
Okay, so I actually like her free skate. I think her programs are much better this season than they've ever been.
That's true. They're better than they have
mm-hmm.
been, but it's not that I don't like her Fire Emblem program. I should amend my statement. I think it looks frantic.
It does. Mm-hmm.
It looks really frantic, and I'm like, calm down. Like,
I think it's better than her trying to be a princess.
Oh, God. That Phantom program made me so angry.
Well, I was talking about the Sleeping Beauty one.
Oh, that too. That was just, oh, my God. Just, no.
But Ashley Wagner's revised long program has been well received.
I like her Mulan program
mm-hmm.
this time. I actually didn't like her Mulan program last year.
Mm-hmm.
I like it this time.
So you like the changes?
I like the changes. No, it's not growing. There was no way in hell that the program would go. I like the changes.
Okay,
it's pretty good.
Transitions are the key. Ashley, please keep them up.
Please keep them up. And with Gracie, I think that if she stops looking frantic with Firebird, it'll come together and I'll like the program.
Mm-hmm.
We just haven't seen a non-frantic
Firebird. I don't think the judges will care, though.
That's fair. Fair enough.
So with those two, I think, are we in agreement with who's going to be in bronze, which is Courtney Hicks.
It's
mm-hmm.
going to be Courtney versus Mariah, in my opinion.
Me too.
So both train like crazy. Mariah trains like... she's so focused in training,
mm-hmm.
and
I believe that she works hard.
She works so hard
that
she'll fall and jump, immediately get up, do it again, and
mm-hmm.
she'll land it the second time. The focus on her face is amazing.
I mean, this is a girl who goes for the triple axel.
And she'll do like 5 triple axels in a row and change technique each time until she. She trains like nobody's business, and I want her to do really well. I just don't think that she's gonna win bronze this year. I think.
Mm-hmm.
Next year might be good. I think she might make it next year. I will say her free skate's growing on me. After I saw it in person a couple times, it took me a couple times. But
Mariah's. Okay, yeah.
I really like her free skate now. It took me a little while to get used to, though, I will admit.
Same here. I was not a fan of the music edits in the beginning. They're growing on me.
Yeah. So I hope Mariah does well. And I hope at the very least she has a clean nationals.
Mm-hmm.
If she's a clean nationals, I think she'd be tough to stop.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I
For some weird reason I see Pewter as being the highest Mariah could go.
Yeah, me too.
Despite how clean she is. Yeah.
Really? I think if she's clean, she could win bronze, but there's very little chance of her being completely clean.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But her jumps are rotated now, which
mm-hmm.
is good. At least in practice they are. So, come on. For competition, let's do it.
That's right. Now, I want to go back to
Courtney.
Hicks. She's riding on a high from her silver medal win
mm-hmm.
at NHK. So, when you go back and watch that free skate, it was not the cleanest of all performances. But I can see, like, following her on social media, that silver medal has boosted her so much that I think she's going to ride that wave
yeah.
into nationals.
She's a confident person in general,
mm-hmm.
and that serves her very well. But she's also not delusional. Like,
mm-hmm.
she's confident, but she's not delusional. She works her butt off. And I really like that she's been going to Roheen, like, every couple months to do, like, touch-ups. It means that she thinks the choreography is really important this season,
mm-hmm.
and I'm glad she's gotten that message.
Mm-hmm.
So she works on it so well. One thing I will say for her is that I think she's really social media savvy. Like, she's an Instagrammer, she tweets all the time, she posts on Facebook, and I think that she messages people back if you message her. So, like, so I think people have been like, oh, we can, like, actually connect with her. Like, it's not just, like, some random skater we, like, all follow on Twitter. It's like, she'll respond to you if you tweet her and things like that. So I think she's been getting a lot of, like, especially international fans. Like, the Japanese
mm-hmm.
love her. They're starting to really love her
mm-hmm.
because she actually responds to them in person. So I love it. Like, and I hope that carries her. and I hope she makes the world team. I think she could do really well at Worlds.
I would like to see how she does at Worlds.
Yeah.
Question for you. How do you like her programs this season?
I like her short a
mm-hmm.
lot.
I was going to say, I like her short better than her long.
That's
Brittany
choreographed it.
Oh, who did the long?
I don't know. But yeah, I know he did the short, and I Dora the Explorer program, and I've watched her work.
Okay, then that makes sense, because I assumed that he did both programs, and I was like, I really like the short and not the long for some weird reason. Okay.
Yeah, so it's a great short, and she works her butt off in training, so.
Okay, do you think we will see a triple axel attempt from Courtney or Mariah?
Mariah, yes, Courtney, no.
Okay.
I don't think Courtney is silly enough to put it out of nationals when she hasn't attempted in competition before. Mariah has put it in competition before.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's not going to go in the short program, but it'll go in the free skate, I think. So I
think that's a better strategy than Mariah did, where it's in the short only and not
in
the long.
That's dumb.
Yeah.
Yeah. Especially because her double axel is gorgeous. I love Mariah's double axel.
I know.
Yeah, like,
so do
keep
I.
Keep it clean. Clean programs are good. All right. We should probably talk about Mariah Bell.
Mariah Bell, who has not really stepped up this season
when
many of us expected her to.
Yeah, especially after such a gorgeous skin match.
I don't think she's had a positive outing at all. None of her senior meetings got Skate America.
Yeah, she hasn't had a positive outing this season, and her practices have been really rough. I haven't been back for a few months, but her practices have been really tough.
So that tells me that it's something beyond the triple-triple. Because I know she's been attempting that, and that's a difficult one for her to get.
I think it's tough for her to keep her confidence up.
Mm-hmm.
And especially when everyone around her and some younger skaters are doing some tough jumps as well. So it's tough for her to keep her confidence up. But that's the key for her. She needs to maintain that confidence.
So maybe her mentality should not be, I need to make the podium at nationals, just kind of skate your best.
Skate clean.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's all we can ask of her at this point, and I think that'll earn her more respect than if she tries to go for more difficult elements and she fails, because then she might not even place top 10 if that happens.
I'm having a hard time remembering what her programs are. They're both choreographed by Raheem.
Yeah.
What
the Freeskies Center, the Nancy Kerrigan one.
Oh, I do remember that one.
Yeah, and I've actually only watched her practice her free skate. I've never seen her practice her short, ever.
I can't remember what her short is. I feel like I liked it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I can't remember, which is really sad. But
so Mariah, I would say top six?
Top. I think that's stretching it.
Okay.
I think that's stretching
it. That's being nice with top six.
Yeah, I think that's stretching it, because we also have Angela Wang this year. Like, she has done well this year.
I don't see her as a threat, though.
She's not a threat for the podium, but I think she's a solid top six. Especially because, like, and again, this is going to sound terrible.
She's placed lower than 10th before at Nationals.
She has, and recently. But she doesn't have Josh this year.
Mm-hmm.
And she did place first at a senior B or something. So, she did pretty decently. So, I think she's a solid top six finish.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. So, not having Josh in the rink, I think, has really helped her keep her focus. So, I think she'll do okay this season.
Nonetheless, she's a beautiful skater. I've never seen her put it together in the long program. I've seen some clean shorts before.
Yeah, I think she's training harder this year.
Okay,
which
that's
is good.
Good.
So, it's I think she'll be top six. Polina.
You know, I can see her making the podium. It's hard to place her on there right now when making the predictions.
Yeah.
Because I think, I don't want to say she's slipping in the standings, but she's not rising when she should be. And I don't think she has been since her Olympic experience.
Right. So there's two issues with her. One, criticism. She will not listen to criticism. And yeah, there's an element of you need to filter criticism, but there's a difference between that and not taking it.
Mm-hmm.
She does look like a junior.
Mm-hmm.
She really does. The packaging is not good for a senior lady. There are some things she really needs to fix. So, and she just won't listen to anyone. Her mom won't listen to anyone either. And I think that's creating a real problem for her in the long run. I think she needs a new choreographer, a new dressmaker. She just needs a new outlook on the sport. And she's not going to get it as long as she's home.
Mm-hmm.
So,
you know what? I keep thinking of Paulina. So I want to like look down on paper and my notes are like, oh, she's, you know, pretty consistent, you know, artistic enough. But
she's not even that consistent this year. Like, she's been falling so much on jumps.
Has she been?
Yeah, she's fallen so much on jumps. And, like, she's not even that consistent anymore. And, like, she had the excuse last year of growing. And, yeah, I get it. Growing sucks. But she should have figured it a little bit by now. Perhaps not completely, mm-hmm. but she should have figured it out a little bit by
and
now.
And I think because she's kind of not gained the respect of the international judges yet,
yeah.
that I think that's going to filter on to the U.S. national judges
yeah.
as well. Because they propped her up for a little bit.
A little
the past
bit.
Two seasons.
Especially because she did so well that breakout
mm-hmm.
year. But yeah, I think the support for her is starting to die down. So that's one issue I have with her. Is just she doesn't listen to anyone.
Mm-hmm.
The second,
I think she also thinks she's better than she actually is.
Yes, she's, yeah, absolutely. And that's part of the, that's skater delusion right there. But then the other issue I have with her is fundamental just lack of maturity.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not necessarily her fault. I see this with Gracie as well. Neither of them really have a story to tell. Ashley is a story to tell,
mm-hmm.
right? Whereas I think...
And
like,
she needs a story to
she
tell.
She needs a story to tell. And this is not necessarily her fault. And this is like the same like with job interviews. Like they always want to hear who you are as a person because they need to know if like you're going to respond well to pressure and
mm-hmm.
things like that. So they want to know like about hardships in your life. And that's the kind of thing you tend to portray in like a piece. And like when you play, I'm a flute player. So like when I play my flute, I try to pick pieces where I can really relate to the music based on events in my personal life. And they tend to be more tragic things that happen in my life. And I don't think anything like that has happened to Paulina, isn't a bad thing. Let's keep that on the record. It's not a bad thing that nothing bad has happened to her, but that means that she hasn't grown as, you know, as she could have by now. And so there's no story we're going to tell.
And how old
and
is she? 17?
And she's 17.
Okay.
I don't know.
Question, is there time for her to become U.S. champion material? Or has she kind of peaked? Because I've heard both sides of the story.
I think she's peaked,
mm-hmm.
assuming she stays with her mom. I think if she left, she could have a second peak. But I don't think that that staying where she is a good idea if she wants to advance. I think she's tapped out.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense?
That does.
Cool.
Yeah, so Paulina, even if she skates well, I don't see her second mark being more than, like, consistent mid-sevens.
No.
So that's already a deficit between Ashley and Gracie.
Right, because you know Gracie's going to get
ninth. Yeah.
Nationals.
Because I think if she's clean, she can get a bronze medal. But I'm not putting her in that for my predictions. I think fifth? Yeah, fifth. So maybe behind Courtney or Mariah Nagasu.
I put her in sixth, actually,
really?
Behind Angela Wang, because I think Angela's going to
wow.
be better. Yeah.
I will say that Angela Wang has a killer combination if it's landed
yeah.
in one program. It was a left toe, double toe.
I think so. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
it's good when it's on, but when it's on. But I think she'll pull it together
mm-hmm.
this year.
Do you have Karen Chen anywhere? We should at least discuss
that. We should
that.
Talk about Karen Chen. Oh my god, what a rocky season.
Mm-hmm.
It's been sad. Like, sad to watch. Someone with, you know, she's so gorgeous on the ice. She's really fierce. I love watching her, but...
She's a really fast skater.
She's really fast.
She goes into her jumps like no other.
Yeah, I think she's a little uncontrolled in the air, too.
Yeah.
That's part of the issue, but this needed to be her breakout year on the Grand Prix. It
mm-hmm.
needed to be, and it wasn't. And that's a problem.
Yeah, and I was saying earlier today to Alokia... when you make a splash at Nationals,
yeah.
you're
expected
to
follow
back
up.
Yeah, which she hasn't really done.
No,
she didn't even perform well at Junior Worlds
no.
last year. So
no.
that's pretty unfortunate.
Yeah, so she just seems like a really inconsistent skater.
And I think Skate America was kind of her moment to shine.
It was, because that was her first time senior on the international stage with everyone watching her. That was her chance, and she really blew it, I
mm-hmm.
thought. So... Yeah, I don't even think she's going to make top six this year because I think that it's a stronger field.
And under rotations are her problems.
Under
rotations. She goes for the triple triples.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I don't think she's going to even make top six this year. So,
mm-hmm.
it's really sad, but I think leaving Tammy might be a good idea.
Mm-hmm. Tammy has so many skaters. I don't know how she does it. Granted, I think a lot of the coaches are accepting more and more skaters these days. I don't know how
we don't have enough coaches in this country.
Yeah, yeah.
Honestly, that's
issue.
The problem. Like when I'm like thinking of like, okay, there are some skaters I think that could do better with everyone else, but who the heck is taking
mm-hmm.
like more students? Because like let's see, we have Raph, we have Jerry also. We have Tammy, Tom, Corey, a couple people in Boston, like one person in Boston. Mm. He's coaching Ross Snyder, but it's not somebody I would really recommend for his singles because how Ross is doing.
Are you talking about Mark and Peter?
Yeah, Mark and Peter. That's who it is. Couldn't remember their names for a second. That's like it. Right?
Yeah, I think most of the skaters are now, like, staying with their childhood coaches.
Yeah.
Which is, like, comfortable, but I don't think that's
what's
needed.
It's not necessarily a good thing. You need to up, right? You need to up your level at some point.
And even everyone's talking about this. Frank Carroll, how good of a coach is he?
Oh,
I forgot
about
crazy.
Even Frank. Yeah. He has too many skaters right now. I love that Frank had to be told by someone that she could do triple. I was like, someone told him that. I'm like, this tells me how much you're paying attention to your students. We don't have enough coaches in this country. That's fundamentally a problem.
I've even said to some people regarding some of our female skaters, oh, maybe they could go to Brian Orser. No, he has like all of
them. He has everyone. And I think he's better with
and
them.
What American,
yeah.
No offense, what American wants to move to Russia to train?
Yeah.
I wouldn't. I can see Canada, not like overseas.
I feel like you'd be looked down on. Mm-hmm. Like, you would not, you wouldn't even be third or fourth priority with a Russian coach. Like, you'd be bottom priority. So that's also the problem.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, we just don't have good coaches. And there are not many people moving into coaching. I think we need a couple more Corey Yates to happen. Like, we need a couple coaches to like random little coaches like break out on the scene, have a national champion or an Olympian, and establish a training base. We need a couple more of those because we
is Yuka Sato still coaching? Does she have?
I don't think
room?
So.
Okay.
I think she's.
Because when Jason and Yuka were together, they were I thought a powerful team.
They were
Alyssa and Jeremy.
They were good for a couple of years,
mm-hmm.
but then I think the flaws in their coaching techniques started to show through when all they would do is reach like second, maybe first at nationals, but not go anywhere
mm-hmm.
internationally. So yeah, we need more coaches. More coaches would be great.
Mm-hmm.
So, some random coach, please come out, you know.
Or former skater.
Or former skater.
Coach.
Rachel Flatt. I feel like she could be a good coach. I mean, she's going to medical school, but there's no way she'll ever be
coaching. I think
she's
coaching, not at the elite level.
Not
yet.
Heavily, yeah, but she's in medical school.
And you know, sometimes when I'm on Ice Network and I'm watching regionals and sectionals, I see, like, a lot of the same coaches there.
Yeah.
So, I guess...
Yeah.
A lot of the coaches take, like, lower levels to elite level
right.
skaters.
And the other problem with lack of coaching and or having the same coach for a long time is they just, you know, you always want a new set of eyes on what you're doing. So,
mm-hmm.
like, I have a flute student, and I've had her for 3 years now. So I've become immune to some of her perpetual problems because at some point you have to, like, ignore them and move on and deal with other stuff because you know it's going to be a perpetual problem.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, yeah, you can do your best to fix it, but at some point only she can do it. So, like, after I'd run out of ways trying to fix it, there are some things I sort of let go. I stopped hearing as a result. And so I asked my friend Brian to, like, come and help, like, listen to her once and make a couple comments, and he picked up on every single thing.
Wow.
It's like you need that outside perspective, and because he has a different way of thinking than I do. Like, she actually fixed a couple things
mm-hmm.
that I'd tried to be on her for a couple of years about, and I just failed at, and he succeeded immediately. So, like, you need that outside perspective just because people are different and they have a different way of doing things, and, you know, a way I do things is not necessarily better, but sometimes the way I say something is not necessarily the way Kira understands it. And so having a different voice is good for that.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
I mean, how do we get more coaches? Do we, like, bribe them over
from Russia? Well, I mean, we did it with Inga with Pear, so... I'd be down. Let's get some of those.
Or maybe it takes the skaters being super self-motivated. But that's a rarity these days.
Yeah. I mean, Caroline's tried, but...
Yeah. Not everyone's a Michelle Kwan, so...
Yeah, and Michelle's not going to coach. I wish Tara would coach.
That would be interesting.
It'd be interesting. I feel like she could... She'd teach the grit
yeah.
at the very
mm-hmm.
least. She is very critical.
So I'm saying if she's critical as a commentator, hopefully she could be as critical as a coach.
Yeah,
only
exactly.
the toughest of the tough get to be with her long term.
Yeah.
That's what I'm hoping.
Jenny Kirk.
Jenny? Do you want to?
Yeah, that'd be fun. She's going to law school, though.
Oh.
So, but yeah, like Jenny, she's coaching a little bit this year, and I've heard she's actually done really well, which is really good to hear. So,
nice.
We need more coaches.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, so I think that's a wrap.
Yeah.
What are you most excited about with Nationals?
Oh, God, Jason Streetskate.
Jason Streetskate.
Like, he'll fall, even if he falls on every jump, I'm going to enjoy it. Because it's going to be freaking gorgeous.
Nice. I am most excited to see, what are they called? The fluff pieces.
Oh, God.
Because they're always so overdone. Gracie, Ashley.
We're going to get an engagement story out of Alexa. Okay.
So, not going to lie, I love the fluff pieces in the beginning just as much as the actual skating.
It's
like very,
so dramatic.
It's like so opera-esque. I know. I
My mother lives for that. She thinks they're awesome, and I'm like, that's contrived, and you know it. But she's like, I don't care, it's so awesome. I'm like, good lord, you have a PhD in chemistry. You should be better than this.
Well, we've been talking for an hour.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. If you've made it this far, thank you for watching.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Right, thank you,
Loki.
Yeah,
absolutely.
All right, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.
Bye.